Clemson, 30. Louisville, 24. Okay, like, I got the cover here with Clemson, but I still don't feel good about them. They
looked awful. They looked absolutely awful. Cunningham
post-game
played
win expectancy.
His ass off.
Post-game win expectancy here. Louisville, 77%.
Yeah, so because you work under the assumption that that final drive, Cunningham played his ass off to get down to the goal line, whatever. The entire fourth quarter, he's limping every play. That guy has played hurt the entire season. Yeah. I don't know that I've seen a game where him – there's never – what Matt Corral's doing at Ole Miss is unbelievable. Nobody is carrying a team the way Cunningham's carrying Louisville.
Cunningham, by the way, 12 out of 20 – excuse me, 12 out of 20 passing, 174 yards. He had 22 carries for 134 yards and two touchdowns. And that was against a really, really good Clemson defense. He did everything that he possibly could to win this game. Yards per play, Louisville won this 5.7 to 5.1. They ran more plays. They were 6 of 17 on third down, so that hurt. But Clemson was only 5 out of 14. So, you know, they outgained Clemson 397 to 338. The fact that they got 223 rushing yards, Louisville did, I mean, that's a feat in and of itself against Clemson. Like, Clemson does not allow people to do that. Because it's not been their defense that has lost them ball games. It has been their offense. And, DJ
Satterfield.
Go ahead.
No, I thought Satterfield and Cunningham could move the ball on them and score. They did. They got to 24, and I thought that was going to be enough to win. I didn't think Clemson had the balls to go down the field and punch it in. Absolutely did. Look like shit doing it, and it looked like it was really hard for them against a not great Louisville team. But then Louisville gets the ball back. They got, it's like a minute 20 left, minute 40, something like that left. And they get right down the field in like four plays. And all four of those plays, like I said, Cunningham's just crawling himself back to the huddle. And it's just, I don't know what to do. I haven't seen a guy do this much with so little and do it while it looks like he's just in constant pain. That kid's just... He's somebody that I love to watch.
Yeah.
I don't know that he's great. I don't know that he's the second coming to Lamar or going to be good on the next level. But what he is for Louisville in college football is special.
So the beginning of this ball game, how shocked were you to see, knowing what we know about Clemson's offense and Clemson's defense?
That's right.
And knowing that Cunningham is basically the only weapon for Louisville right now.
Correct.
For Louisville to come out of the gate, six plays, 75 yards, touchdown, and then
score.
And then immediate, Clemson comes back, three plays, 75 yards, touchdown.
Touchdown. Like, yeah, I'll tell you this. One of those things I thought could happen, the other one I didn't, and it's the I thought Louisville was going to be able to score. When they scored fast and scored first, I thought I was right on that, and I liked my chances with that ticket. And then Clemson went down and scored in three plays, and I thought, that's not sustainable. Those were the two thoughts I had after the first two drives. I believed one was sustainable and was what I thought is a little confirmation bias. Yeah. And the other one, I didn't think they could do it all game long. Now, neither one of them were capable of actually doing it all game long. We get a, 24 to 30 final. But I would have bet everything in my world that final drive after Clemson scored. That Louisville was going to score that touchdown to win it.
I will say this. I want to give Satterfield props. Yeah, I want to give Satterfield props because he did not play scared, right? No. I mean, he, like, down at the end of the ball game, they had four plays that gave them 1 yard. It did lead to the last field goal that made it a 30-24 game, and I think that's what he was thinking is, okay, at the end of the day, we're down by three. If we give up a field goal, we can... you know, get the ball back with, you know, just a few seconds left on the clock. But, like, this will be our shot. This is our only shot is if we go for it on fourth down. And they did it. Louisville did have a missed field goal. That sucked. Got down to the Clemson 34.
But the missed field goal doesn't kill it because if they make that, they still need a touchdown, right? Because they're down by six? Another field goal would have tied it.
Another field goal would have tied it because they wouldn't have given up that that last field goal by going for it on fourth down. You know, at their own 26 or whatever it was. So yeah. it the whole thing would have changed had they hit the field goal. But
yeah, I was trying to play out the last couple of possessions after that, and
yeah,
I've seen way too many things before I to remember exactly how it played out. But
so and also, by the way, cheers to Dabo and that bunch for being aggressive. They had a drive that ended on the Louisville 1 yard line, went for it on fourth down, didn't get it, but it pinned them. You know,
that's right.
So that's they did a good job. They did a pretty good job.
I thought Dabo and them were going to let him off the hook. They were trying to save clock at the end. Louisville went for it on third down, didn't get it. No, second down, didn't get it. At the end of the game, Dabo and them caused timeout. Louisville and them ran the ball. There's only 40 seconds left. They got 40 seconds basically to get two plays off, which means they don't get to huddle and they don't get to sub anybody in, because you would eat up all of your 40 seconds. You're not going to get both plays off. As soon as Louisville doesn't get it on second down, Dabo calls timeout. And the announcers are saying, we did that to save his team's clock. If they don't, if they give up the touchdown, they could still go down and kick a field goal. And I thought,
Think that's why he called the timeout. I thought he called it to make sure that his team was in the proper formation.
They had the right defense because he thought maybe if we give up the score, it's the ball game, because we're not scoring with 20 seconds left.
No.
No, see, I thought the same thing. I was really curious, but I'll tell you this. I think if he doesn't call the timeout, I think they have a better shot. Now, it worked out for him because they got the stop.
Yeah.
If Louisville scores there, I think you can hang that loss on Dabo. I would rather say try to get two plays off with a running clock at 40. So by the time you call the second play, we're at 33. And then that play is going to run, and then we're going to spot the football. And then, you know, unless it's incomplete passes. I guess no, because they could have thrown the ball.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, they could have thrown the ball. I just – like, there's a lot of different things that were going into that last little bit. But cheers to them. Like, Clemson has been bad.
It worked out.
Clemson's been bad, but they're not awful, and the defense is still pretty good. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at WinningCures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.